Lord-Ordinators oversee the defence of all of Sigma's Stormkeeps, as well as established beachheads within the Mortal Realms. In today's video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these. So when you're ready, let's get started. The first thing you'll need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here, we've used Retributor Armour. After that, we're going to shade the entire model with Reichland Flesh Aid Gloss. We're going to use the gloss because it will keep that armor nice and shiny. So all we need to do first is give the pot a quick shake. Just apply some to our palette. We don't want to overload the brush. And we're using a medium shade brush for this. I'll just slap a load on there. Just twist it around a bit just to get a little bit of the paint off the bristles. And then we'll just start applying it to the model. I'd recommend applying it all over the model. Make sure you give the gloss shade plenty of time to dry before moving on to the next stage. And for this, we're going to start highlighting all that gold armour. First, we're going to layer with Auric Armour Gold, and then we're just going to edge highlight with Liberator Gold. So starting with Auric Armour, we're just going to get a little bit on our paintbrush, apply it to the palette. I'm going to use a medium layer for this, as there's some large panels and some large areas on that gold armour. But as always, we're just going to thin the paint down a little, just don't want to clog up the details too much. So just spin my brush around to get a nice point to it, like so. And we'll just start layering that armour up. Start on the legs. When doing this, make sure you avoid all those recess areas as you want to keep that shade in there. Just focus on the raised areas. Once you've layered with Auric Armour Gold, we're going to move on to the next stage, which is just to pick out all the highlights and raised details with Liberator Gold. And for this, we're going to do an edge highlight. We're going to use a small layer brush. And the key to this is to get a nice point. So just get a little bit on your palette, like so, and really twist it. Now, there will be times when you're painting and it will splay, but don't worry about that. Just get back to your palette and give it a nice twist just to get a good point. You can thin it down a bit as well, but with metallics, the danger there is it'll make it too thin. So just be careful when doing any kind of highlighter. Just take your time. And then we'll just start running it around the edges of the model. Now, areas like this, you can just use the edge of your brush and just run it along like so. Same for like the shoulder pauldron. But any other areas that, like the feet here, you can just, you have to use the point of your brush to do this. Just take your time. With the gold now highlighted, we're ready to move on to painting the black areas. And for this, we're gonna be base coating with Abaddon Black. We're then gonna highlight with Eshin Grey and then do a final highlight of Dawnstone. Starting with Abaddon Black, we'll just use a small layer brush, apply some to our palette, we'll thin this down, a couple of touches of water to it, and we'll just start applying it. Just make sure we get our bristles to a nice point as always. We've got the areas like the belt to do, right here. Also, back of the legs, just around the armor joints, on the back of the knee pad there. There's also the gauntlets here. With the black areas base coated, we're going to begin highlighting with Eshin Grey. And for this, we want to do broad highlights because we want the next highlight to be quite obvious as well. So doing all the gloves and the belts. So take your time, don't rush. And we're using a small layer brush for this. Don't forget the belt and the pouches. With the Eshin Grey applied, we're going to move on to a fine edge highlight of Dawnstone. And for this, you just want to keep it really fine, just so you're showing some of that Eshin Grey through on either side. Do the edge there using the edge of the brush. Also the same for the belt as well. Make sure you get your brush to a nice point, otherwise all your hard work will be undone. Take your time, and always use the smallest brush you can for this. Now that the black's finished, we're going to move on to painting the robes and the parchment. We're going to base and highlight them the same, but we are going to use two different shades to represent different tones. So first we're going to start with Rakar Flesh. Just apply that using a medium layer brush. So allow us to just get a decent amount of coverage on the model. We will thin it down as well, as always. But just make sure you keep twisting those bristles to get it to a nice point. We'll start applying it. front of the model. So for the robes, you've got just on the front here, the tabard. It's also just out the back there as well. And the inside of the cloak, it's one of the areas. The parchment is just this little fella here. We'll just base coat that as well. Once the Rakar flesh is dry, we're going to begin shading. And for this, we're going to use Reichland flesh shade for the robes. We're not going to use the gloss version, we'll just use the normal. Just apply it to the palette as always. Just add a little bit of water to it just to thin it down slightly. I'll be using a medium layer brush as well, just to give me a bit more control. So let's start applying it to the robes. Just apply it to the front there. You've also got underneath the cloak as well. Remember not to apply it onto the parchment, we'll be using a different shade for that. Once the Reichland flesh shade is dry, we're just going to shade that little bit of parchment with some Seraphim Sepia. So again, we'll use a medium layer brush, just apply a little bit to our palette. I won't thin this down, I'll just use it straight from the pot, so give it a bit of strength. And then we'll just apply it on straight, like so. Make sure you allow it to run into those cracks to show off those words. That shade dry, what we're going to do now is use Rakar flesh again, but we're just going to tidy up some of those raised areas. So any areas on the cloth, on the robes and on the parchment. We'll just use a little bit of Rakar, we'll use a small layer brush, we'll just thin it down slightly. Just going to get a nice point to the bristles by twisting it around, like so. And then just start on the robe there, just pick out some of the folds in the cloth. Like so. Same for the parchment as well. Just run it around the edges a bit. With the robes and parchment now tidied up, we're just going to start applying pallid witch flesh to the raised areas. We'll use a small layer brush. As always, apply a little bit to the palette. Just use a little bit of water. We're only picking out raised details, really, really fine details here, so make sure your brush is at a nice point. We'll just start doing it. Pick a bit here. Like so, and just run it down the edge of the parchment, using the edge of your brush. With the robe and parchment now highlighted, we're going to move on to the tabard and the weapon halves. And for this, we're going to use Screamer Pink. We're then going to shade it with Norn Oil and then highlight with Pink Horror. So first of all, we're going to use a medium layer. And as always, I'm going to use the palette. Make sure I get plenty of paint on there. Just thin it down slightly. Because there's a lot of texture to the quilted area on the tabard, it's better to actually have it a little bit runny so it can go into all those crevices. Just make sure we get a nice point to the brush. And then we'll just start slapping it on. Like so. Obviously we've got the weapon halves here. Remember to do this in a couple of thin coats as well. Once the Screamer Pink's dry, we're going to start applying Norn Oil. What I will say is just on the back there where the tools are, don't worry about getting Screamer Pink in the cracks because that's actually quilted detail there and you want to have that. And we'll paint those later anyway. So let's start applying that Norn Oil. We'll just slap it on here. And again, I'll just apply it into these recesses as well. We'll also be doing it on the weapon halves. And when doing this, make sure it doesn't pull. The best way is to use a medium layer brush. With the Norn Oil now dry, all we need to do is start highlighting the quilting. For this, we're just going to do little crosses in the centre of each quilt. Take your time with this and use a small layer brush. That'll give you more control. Also, we've got the weapon halves to do. So where all the strappings are, just take your time and just pick out the edges of those as well. Now that all those highlights are applied to the magenta areas, we're going to move on to painting the silvers. And for this, we're going to use the Lead Belcher. We're then going to shade with Norn Oil and then highlight with Stormo Silver. So starting with Lead Belcher, I'm going to use a medium layer brush for this. Again, as always, add a bit to the palette and thin it down as well. Might be better making it a little bit more thinner than normal, just because it will help flow into a lot of the recesses. Now, there's a few areas of silver to paint on here. There's all his tools, there's his hammers. So if we just start with the tools at the front here, so you've got all those there. Got some tools here as well. Also got the hammers to do, like so. There's also the tools on the back as well, so we won't neglect them. As you can see, I've base coated all those areas silver, but I've also picked out his emblem on his knee, the brooch here, and the area on the back there as well. The next stage is to start applying Norn oil over all those silver areas. I'm going to use a small layer brush for this. We're just going to take our time and just start applying that on. Using a small layer brush is probably better because it gives you more control and you won't start splodging other areas as well. With all the silver areas now shaded, we're going to begin highlighting, and for this we're going to use Stormhost Silver. So as always, just thin it down a bit on a palette and then just start picking out the details. Now for most of the areas, I'm just going to, like on these beads here, just pick them out. For any highlights on the hammers, just going to run with the edge of my brush like this. Also at this point, you can use the Stormhost Silver to start picking out some of the gold details, just to give a bit more contrast. So such as areas like the rivets, like here, just to pick them out and give them a nice striking look, and also around the edges. With all those metallic areas now highlighted, we're going to move on to painting the blue areas. And for this, we're going to use Cantor Blue as a base coat. We'll then shade with Drakonoff Nightshade, and then we'll highlight with Elatop Blue. Following that, we'll use Hoef Blue. So starting with Cantor, we're going to use a small layer brush for this because they're quite fine details we need to do now. I'll just thin that down as we always do, with a little bit of water on the palette. Get the bristles to a nice point, and we'll start base coating those areas. So we've got the trim on the tabard to do, so careful not to splodge on the magenta. I mean, if you do, you can just tidy back up with a little bit more for previous stages. So just make sure that's nice and neat. We've also got the shoulder pad as well. So you can see there, it doesn't really matter about getting on the sigil, because we'll paint over that white later. With the Cantor Blue now dry, all we need to do is just start running some Drakonoff Nightshade into the recesses, such as the folds of the cloth here, just on the trim, and onto the shoulder pad as well, like so. Just keep it to the recesses, should be enough. And for this, I recommend using a small layer brush. Once your shade's dry, we're going to move on to the edge highlighting using a Latop Blue. And for this, I'm just going to use a small layer. I'm just going to run my brush around the edge, like so. And same for the cloth as well. We'll just run it around the edge. With that highlight applied, we're now going to use Hoef Blue with a small layer brush and just pick out some of the corners, such as the tabard here. Just using the edge of the brush. Just little raised details like this you just need to pick out. But don't go too far in. You want to leave some of the other colours showing. With the blue areas now complete, we're ready to move on to painting the skin. And for this, it's worth changing your water at this point, as the remaining stages involve lots of light colours. So let's jump onto the skin. For this, we're going to use Bugman's Glow, and I'll use a small layer brush. I'm just going to thin it down, because this will give us more control when we're painting those areas. I'll just twist it to a nice point, and then we'll start applying it. So starting on the face, doesn't matter if you get on the hair, we'll paint over that later. And of course, there's the arms as well. With the skin now based, we're ready to move on to the next stage. And for this, we're going to layer with Cadian Flesh Tone. We're going to do it over all the skin. So I'm going to use a small layer brush. And again, just thinning that paint down. So a couple of drops of water to it. Just get my brush to a nice point, so I've got a bit of control. And then we'll just start layering it on. Remember to do this in two thin coats as well. With the skin now layered, we're ready to run a shade of Reichland Flesh Shade all over the skin. And for this, I'll use a small layer brush. Just apply that to my palette. Add a little touch of water to it. Get it to a nice point for more control. Then we'll just start slapping it on. Just be careful when doing this, you don't want to get on the rest of the model. As you can see, it's really defining those muscles as well. After leaving plenty of time for that shade to dry, we're now going to use Cadian Flesh Tone again, and we're just going to tidy up on those raised areas, like the bridge of the nose, the forehead and the muscles. When using a small layer brush as before, I'm just going to get a little bit on my palette. Now we need to be really neat here, so take your time, don't rush, because you don't want to get it back into the recesses, you want to keep it just on the raised parts. So make sure you get a brush to a nice point, and we'll just start applying the paint on. So again, if you just pick out the nose, brow, forehead, and obviously his big muscles as well. With the skin now tidied, All that's left to do on the skin is to just highlight with Kislev Flesh. And for this, again, we're going to use a small layer brush. Just thin it down slightly to give us more control. Get it to a nice point. Just add a bit more there. Thin that down a bit too much. That will happen, so don't worry. Just get your mix right. Spin it to a nice point. Just as before, we're just going to pick out the brow and the nose, but a little bit thinner than previously. Just like so. And we'll just pick around the muscle areas. Just give it a bit of definition. With the flesh now completed, we're ready to move on to painting all the white details on the hair. And for this, we're going to use Celestial Grey as a base. We'll then shade with Norn Oil, and then after that, we'll layer up with Ulthran Grey and then do some final highlights using White Scar. So first, we're going to use Celestial Grey. I'll be using a small layer brush for all these stages because we'll need that control. Just apply it to the palette like so. Just thin it down slightly with a little bit of water. What we need to do is just keep twisting that brush just so we can get some nice points to it like so. When you're happy with the point that you've got, we'll just start applying it. So the areas I'm going to look at is the hair, obviously, right here. Just lay a few of those areas on, as well as his moustache as well. Don't forget his moustache. And then we've got a couple of details at the bottom, such as there's a little lightning bolt here, which will be white. Also got a twin-tailed comet at the top here. At the back of the hammer, we've got a sigmarite trail just to fill in. And also, we'll need to paint the detail on the shoulder as well. With the white now based, we're going to apply a shade of Norn Oil just to the hair. As it's a different texture, this will really help it stand out. With the shade now dry, we're going to apply Ulthran Grey as a layer to all the little details, such as the lightning bolts and the comet. However, with the hair, we're just going to apply it into little streak motions, just to give the suggestion of hair strands, like so. And the remaining thing now to do on the white is just add a few little details with White Scar just on some of the raised edges and picking out edges. Pick the back of the hammer here, we're just going to run the brush on the side like so, just to give it a nice sharp edge. With the white now finished, we're ready to go on to the final stage, which is to paint the cool glowy effects. These are mainly featured on his hammers, but there are also some gems scattered on the model as well. For this, we're going to start with Incubi Darkness. I'm going to use a small layer brush. Just apply it there to the palette. We'll also thin it down. Obviously, multiple thin layers are better than one thick coat. And we'll just twist the brush to get a nice point to it as well. And then we'll start applying it to the model. So I'm going to do it on the hammer just here. This is like in the center, there's a little orb. That's on both hammers, so you've got one just in here as well. And then you have a gem just on the inside of the cloak on this side. And you have one on this side as well. There's also a little orb just on the back of his back banner. With the Incubi Darkness applied, we're now going to layer it with Sotek Green. We'll apply this over all the areas, however, when we do the gems, we'll just leave some of that Incubi Darkness shown to give it a cool gem effect. So what we're going to do is just use a small layer brush. We'll thin this down a little bit more just so it goes over those areas a bit easier. We'll do some multiple thin coats as well. And then just get it to a nice point. Start applying it on. There we go. We'll just literally just apply that straight over with the Incubi Darkness on these orbs. Same for the back there on the back banner. However, on the gem, we're going to do about just over half. So just showing some of that incubi on one side, like so. With that layer applied, we're now going to highlight. And for this, we're going to use Temple Guard Blue. We'll use a small layer brush. We're just going to apply some to the palette. We'll thin it down. With the orbs, we're just going to highlight because they've got little ridges on them to highlight. Whereas with the gems, we're going to do what we did previously and just show some of those previous colours under to give it a cool gem effect. So get our bristles to a nice point and then we'll just start highlighting. So on the orb here, there's like some little raised areas we can just pick out. Just take your time. And then on the gem, go about just under halfway. Again, that will show some of those colours through and start to give it a cool effect. With that step now done, all that's left is to apply Pallid Witch Flesh as little dots. This will give a cool light source. So firstly, we're going to get a small airbrush. We'll thin this down. Not too much, mind, as we don't want it too runny. So just a little bit and get it to a nice point. And there's some natural areas on these orbs that you can actually just pick out. So the one on the back of his back banner, it's just a couple of areas that actually look like dots. So if you just apply there, there's one and there. And on the gem, all we're going to do is just do a little dot in one of the corners. And it's better to do it on the dark side as opposed to the light side. Like so. That'll give it a cool gem effect. Also, if you really want to, just apply it to his teeth. He's got some just under his moustache there. And with that, the Lord Ordinator is completed. All that's left to do is to base him, and I recommend base him in the colour scheme that suits your army. With the model now finished and based, he's ready to protect the Stormkeeps and bring ruin to Sigma's foes. There are a few key points to remember when painting this model. Firstly, always thin your paints down, as multiple thin layers are far better than one thick coat, as we don't want to clog up those details. Secondly, neatness is key, so always make sure that you just take your time when doing any edge highlighting. And lastly, when using any metallics, just change your water as often as you can, as you don't want to taint the other colours. I hope you guys have found this tutorial useful and helpful, and have fun painting your own Lord Ordinators, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.